Hey folks, today we're going to be making some whitefish pate puree for this big guy right here. His name is Tyler, and he's very hungry.
First, we want to make sure that we're cooking the whitefish because some whitefish, most whitefish, contains the enzyme deaminase, which it would mess up with the cat's digestive system, and they won't be able to get all the vitamins and nutrients from the fish itself. So what we want to do, we want to cook the whitefish first, so the cat could absorb all the nutrients correctly. So step one, we have our whitefish here, and we're gonna wrap it in some parchment paper in order to keep the juices cooked with the fish. So we'll line them all up here. Now, baking the fish, real simple. You want to make sure you set it to 400 degrees, anywhere from 15 to 17 minutes, dependent upon the power of your oven here. I'm gonna set it to 17, and we'll check them after that.
Almost done. In the meantime, here's a picture of the cats. All right. Looks about done.
Smells good. Yep, flakes apart. Yeah, these are definitely done. All right, so now the goal, another fork here, is to just separate them, flake them all down. Now you could do it this way and have that horrid sound, or you could throw it all in a blender and see how that goes. Actually gonna try a piece here because I do like whitefish.
Now I didn't use any seasoning, It's Alaskan wild caught pollock. And I'll tell you what, it's really good. Hey, Tyler. Yeah, this is for you.
He smells it. He's ready to go. Jesus! Mary and Joseph. That was... Oh, Tyler's petrified. All right. Looks good. Good enough to eat, right? I'd eat that. All right. Time to... for storage. Now, this stuff, the fish, it could be refrigerated, I would say up to four to five days. I'm trying to, my cat Tyler is a big boy, so he's trying to lose some pounds. So I'm cutting out the grains for a couple days so he could shed some of that weight he's put on the past couple months. But I'm sure he won't mind because this is some good eating here. Now you don't feed it to them hot. They don't like hot and they don't like it cold. They don't like the extremes. But the adequate temperature for a furry feline friend would be about the temperature of a living mouse. If you guys could determine that on your own. All right. So I'm gonna get this in here and. Get it cooled down a little bit, and then we'll see how he likes it. It's coming, buddy. Don't worry. He's hungry. And Keiko, I don't know if you'll like it. Keiko likes his canned pate. Salmon only. Nothing else. Tyler's waiting so patiently for his food to cool down. He wants his food now. You hungry, buddy? High five. I'd say it's a success. Yeah, he's usually a lot more enthusiastic about it, but we'll give it a thumbs up. And this isn't going to be his diet forever. This is just something new to try from the other grain stuff. So, hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope. You actually enjoy the fish, Tyler. We'll try something else next time and see how you like it. Thanks, guys. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe for more content about cats and food and more cats.